pop superstar Taylor Swift and football icon Lionel Messi are the biggest crowd drawers this 2023. Swift's The Eras Tour and Messi's matches with Inter Miami were the biggest ticket sellers of the year, according to StubHub. The Eras Tour grossed about $2.2 billion in North American ticket sales alone. Meanwhile, Messi's transfer to MLS team Inter Miami was a boon for ticket sales for the league, which rose 160%. Before Messi mania took over, Inter Miami ranked just 13th in ticket sales among MLS squads. Our numbers that matter this Friday, $2.97 billion. That is the trade deficit in the Philippines' agriculture goods in the third quarter. Now, that figure is higher than the $2.71 billion in the quarter before that. It is, however, lower than last year's over $3 billion deficit. Meanwhile, agricultural trade, or the sum of exports and imports, fell by 12% to $6.2 billion. This reverses last year's growth of 17.5%. Friday's Hotel Group, which owns hotel resorts in popular tourist destinations in the Philippines, sets its sights on further expansion. Currently, the firm has properties in Puerto Galera and Boracay in Aklan, which is set to reopen in 2026. Now, it also has another resort in development that's located in Siargao.
We, of course, hope to expand our Friday's brand, maybe in Palawan, maybe in a new and upcoming island like Cebu. We still don't have a presence there. So, of course, we're open to any and all opportunities. We will not be closing our doors to that. We are going into a new norm where people do want to stay at resorts for a longer period. And that is the trend that we see with our clients in Puerto Galera. And hopefully that trend remains for our two other resorts that we will open soon.
Cebu Pacific, the Gokongwei family owned airline, launches direct flights to the rising tourist destination of Da Nang in Vietnam. The budget carrier said its flights from Manila to the coastal Vietnamese city will operate thrice a week. That's every Tuesday, Thursday, and Saturday. Now, Da Nang is known for its luxury resorts and architecture. It's also the gateway to three UNESCO World Heritage Sites. Cebu Pacific also flies to the Vietnamese cities of Ho Chi Minh and the capital, Hanoi. The Philippine province of Cavite and the National Irrigation Administration ink a memorandum of agreement on the efficient use of the province's water resources. This formalizes the agreement, which reassigns existing water rights and optimizes the use of excess water without compromising the essential irrigation needs of the agricultural sector. Now, as part of that initiative, the NIA's excess irrigation water will now prioritize municipal use. Proponents say this move is aligned with President Ferdinand Marcos's thrust to maximize the country's water resources. Philippine factory output grows at a slower pace in October. Government data showed the value of growth in production slowed to 1.3% from the 9.6% in September. It's also significantly lower than last year's 14.5% growth. Growth in volume of production in October was also down. It stood at 1.7% against the 9.9% the month before that. The Statistics Bureau points to the double-digit annual drop in the manufacture of beverage, particularly in the beverage industry division, for this decline. Still in the U.S., the son of President Joe Biden is indicted on tax evasion charges. The new complaints accuse Hunter Biden of failing to pay $1.4 million in taxes while spending millions of dollars on a lifestyle that is lavish. Hunter was slapped with 3 felony and 6 misdemeanor tax offenses. If convicted now, he could face 17 years in prison. He was indicted on gun charges in September. Saudi Arabia and Russia, the world's two biggest oil exporters, call on other oil-producing nations to cut output, saying this will benefit the global economy. Their call comes after Russian President Vladimir Putin's lightning visit to the Arab states. More in this report.
Russian President Vladimir Putin arrived in the United Arab Emirates Wednesday on a lightning visit, one that the Russian authorities and state media are playing up. This is one of the few foreign trips Putin has made since he ordered his troops to invade Ukraine. The trip was politically charged, but Putin assured Russians it had an economic component.
A number of large projects in the oil and gas sector are being implemented. We also cooperate with OPEC Plus.
OPEC Plus is a group of countries allied with OPEC, led by Russia. Both Russia and the UAE are highly dependent on their oil and gas revenues, and although they are in very different political situations, experts believe they share common objectives.
Putin is not traveling alone. So he has quite a large delegation of people, most of whom are representing not only political sector of the Russian government, but also the economic affairs. So we definitely should expect them discussing the situation in the oil market and further coordination of efforts within OPEC Plus.
In the context of Moscow's confrontation with the West, the Kremlin sees an opportunity in this type of high-level meeting to show its domestic audience that Russia is not isolated despite international sanctions. In addition to the UAE, Putin's tour included Saudi Arabia, which has close relations with Washington. As the war between Israel and Hamas continues to make international headlines, analysts say images of Putin visiting with the Saudis give Moscow an opportunity to portray itself as a counterweight to the United States.
The West and the United States especially, but Europe too, has so significantly sided with Israel, right? And certainly in the Middle East, it is the West is perceived as sort of completely uncritically siding with Israel. And that helps Russia's narrative of arguing that, you know, the West is this imperialist, hegemonic power that has all these double standards.
Russia faces a second winter in its war against Ukraine, international isolation, and an economy weakened by a drop in world oil prices. All of these elements forcing the Russian leadership to look to its few remaining friends. For the VOA Moscow Bureau, Elizabeth Cherneff, VOA News.